The reputed Bishop Darcy letter has never been proved genuine. None of the copies of the Darcy letter that we have is signed or dated. There's also no proof that the Pope ever saw it or that it was even delivered to him. And besides, no trace or hint of identity has ever been found of the artist, who, if he ever made the image on the shroud, would have belonged among the ranks of Michelangelo, Da Vinci, and Raphael.
The image on the Shroud of Turin is negative, meaning that the lights and darks are reversed from the way we would normally see with our eyes. Assuming that the shroud were manufactured in the 14th century, it would mean someone would have had to have conceived of the concept of photography approximately 650 years before it was invented. I don't think so.
If the shroud is a fake, it is probably the most astonishing fake of all time. If it is genuine, then it is arguably the first visible evidence of Christ's crucifixion and may literally be a photographic record of his resurrection.
In 1973, the shroud was brought out for a brief examination by a group of European scientists. Among them was the late Dr. Max Frey, a Swiss criminologist and one of the leading experts in dust and pollen analysis in the world. Dr. Frey almost single-handedly developed a technique to determine where criminals had been by testing samples of dust and pollen from their clothing. At first, Dr. Frey's objective was simple. If the shroud was forged in France in the 14th century, then only the French or Italian pollens would be found in the cloth. But his exhaustive analysis found some 58 specific pollens, only 17 of which were indigenous to Europe. The rest were from Palestine and southern Turkey, the site of Edessa and Constantinople. And this meant that the shroud had been in these places at some time in its history. It has been alleged that the type of linen, the herringbone pattern weave, was very rare in the Palestine area, but that it was a very common textile after the 12th century in Europe. This is simply not true. Neither the linen nor the weave were common in Europe. This same pattern is identical to mummy wrappings that go back as far as 2000 BC. Joseph of Arimathea was a wealthy man who received permission from Pilate to bury Christ's body. It is not unlikely that when he gave his tomb for the burial of Christ, he may have also used expensive Middle Eastern linen grave clothes that were intended for his own burial.
The physical shroud itself is one matter for investigation, but even more mysterious and more puzzling is the haunting image which appears on the shroud itself. Next, the startling discoveries of a famous forensic pathologist are revealed, and what new role is 20th century technology playing in the historical drama of the Shroud of Turin? This and more when we come back.